हेलो एवरीवन, वंस अगेन वेलकम टू आवर चैनल न्यूक्लियन बायोटेक। आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग योर स्टडीज़ वेरी वेल। सो स्टार्टिंग टुडे वी आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर नीट। सो आवर फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज़ लिविंग वर्ल्ड। सो स्टूडेंट, बिफोर वी गो टू द लिविंग वर्ल्ड वी शुड नो व्हाट लिविंग मीन्स। सो व्हाट डज टू लिविंग मीन्स? Living means alive now, still used or practiced now. Now what is living world? Living world means living world comprises an amazing diversity of living organisms. That all present living organisms are related to each other and also to all organisms. Not only their categories that ever lived on this earth. So living organisms is formed of many type of inorganic as well as organic biomolecules. Inorganic compounds like water, minerals and always microbiomolecules. This is of small size, low molecular weight, readily soluble in water and diffusible. While in other hand, organic molecule. So what is organic molecule? Organic molecule may be micro, like monosugars, amino acids, or macro biomolecules, which is of large sized, high molecular weight, insoluble or slightly soluble. Not totally insoluble. Examples like protein, fats, nucleic acid, etc. These both type of biomolecules play very important role in metabolism. So role of different type of biomolecules are different. Like role of water, so main role of water, water forms 70 to 90% of cellular pool. Water help in sustaining the life process. So water is called cradle of lips, as life is not possible in the absence of water. On the other hand, role of oxygen. Oxygen is mainly utilized in aerobic cell. In aerobic cell respiration process of nutrients inside the mitochondria. For what? To produce energy rich ATP molecules. So is essential for life. In case of absence of oxygen, only 5% of energy is available is released. Now role of carbohydrate. Carbohydrate are organic compound formed of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, generally in the ratio of 1:2:1. So carbohydrates are the main storage molecules and most organisms use carbohydrate as an important fuel, breaking these bonds and releasing energy to sustain life. So life, it is unique complex organization of molecules that express itself through chemical reactions which lead to growth, development, adaptation, reproduction, responsiveness. Now come to the example of life. An example of life is a person who is breathing, walking, talking. An example of life is a plant with green leaves still rooted in the ground. An example of life is all the plant living in a pond. These are the examples of life. Now what is living beings? Come to the point, what is living beings? Living beings are made up of a cell or cells. They obtain and use energy to survive. A unique ability to reproduce, ability to grow, ability to metabolize, ability to respond, or ability to adapt to the environment, and last but not the least, an ability to respire. Most living things need food, water, light, temperature within defined limit and oxygen. On the other hand, non-living things are all the things that are not classified as living things.
The objective, exhibiting growth, development, reproduction, respiration, and other characteristics of life are designated as living beings.
So, for an organism to be living, there are some features that are imperative. Some of these are growth, reproduction, metabolism, self-organized, and motility. First of all, nomenclature, the process of rendering scientific name to organism. ICBN and ICZN were advanced to appoint scientific name for plant and animals both. The name would have two segments, generic name and specific or species name. This arrangement of providing name with two components is called in binomial nomenclature. So binomial nomenclature, coined by Linnaeus. Example, Homo sapiens. Here Homo is the generic name and sapiens is the specific name, species name. Now come to the classification. Classification, it is the process of assigning creatures in specific classes or group. Consider same defined characters. These group are known as taxa. Now what is taxonomy? It is the process of identification, nomenclature, and organization of life forms. Consider the inner and outer cell structure, biological data, and advancement process. Now systematics, investigating life form in association to identification, nomenclature, arrangement, and evolutionary. Now come to the taxonomic categories. It depicts the rank or level in the hierarchical arrangement in ascending order. The seven mandatory categories as listed below: kingdom, division, class, order, family, genus, species. So kingdom, it includes different phyla of animals and different plant divisions. Now come to division or phylum. It incorporates related classes as a division in plants and phylum in animals. Class, many orders related to each other are incorporated into a class. Now order includes a few related families. Now family, it is an assembly of related genera. Genus, a gathering of related animal categories having similar characters. Now come to the species, the essential unit in classification. Species refer to the individuals from any animal group that are firmly related, obtained from a typical ancestors, which can interbreed to produce offsprings which are fertile themselves. Now come to the taxonomic aids. Taxonomic guide or taxonomic aids refer to a technique, stored information and process useful in identification and classification of entities. They are herbarium, museums, zoological parks, botanical gardens. Okay, thank you. Don't forget to like and also subscribe our channel. Thank you. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay home.